Hi, welcome to another video. In today's video, we are going to talk about how to eliminate undesirable behaviour for good. My name is Darren Chow and I'm the English tutor from EnglishTuition.org. Now, very often, when students exhibit some form of bad behaviour, schools like to implement detention as a form of punishment. The question is, does it work? Maybe punishment alone is not enough, especially when we see the very same students repeating the same old behavior over and over again. And that can be very tiring. So how do we ensure that the same behavior does not always come back? I think what the schools should have done is to get students to reflect more on their behavior. Very often when students attend detention, they are given some worksheets to do or they are given nothing to do. In other words, the treatment that they get during detention can be kind of random, and I don't think that is a good thing. So what we can have is to maybe get the students to write a piece of reflective essay about the bad behavior that have caused them to get detention in the first place. And at the same time, in that very same essay, they should mention what they have learned from the episode. And if they don't hand in the essay at the end of the detention, or if the essay is not satisfactory, then the detention itself doesn't count. Something along those lines, and I think that will work better in the long run. Because if you don't get students to learn from their own mistakes, and we continue to give out punishment, then I think the schools will eventually end up with a room full of students going for detention, because they are going to keep repeating the same old mistakes again and again. Again, let me repeat. The key is to get the students to reflect so that they learn something from the episode, and we can ensure that they don't repeat the same undesirable behavior over and over again. And we have to send them the message that if they keep misbehaving or keep repeating the same behavior, then they will have to come back to detention and learn the lessons all over again. So for myself, in the course of my teaching, sometimes when I find that students misbehave or there's some kind of undesirable behavior that keeps repeating over and over, I do not just progress and just move on. Very often, I will pause and I'll make sure that the students reflect on what had happened so that they learn something from it before I allow them to move on. And so far, that has been pretty effective for me. So to sum up this entire video, I think if we can get our students to reflect more on their behavior, they will end up becoming better students, and hopefully that translates to better studying habits and better results. Let me know what you think about using reflection as a tool to eliminate bad behavior in the comment section below. If you'd like to see further videos like this one, please head on to my YouTube channel, subscribe to the channel, or you can follow us on our Facebook page. The videos are 100% free. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye.